Right. So in the last class, we have started discussing about the condition for maximum efficiency for Pelton wheel. So as you can see in the screen, we have got the condition for maximum efficiency when U is equal to V1 by 2. That is vane velocity when equal to half of the jet velocity. So we get maximum efficiency in case of Pelton wheel turbine. And this is the maximum value of the hydraulic efficiency of Pelton wheel turbine. That is 1 plus cos pi by 2. So we have to remember these two conditions. Then we later will talk about some design aspects of Pelton wheel turbine. Okay, like what is jet velocity formula, vane velocity or wheel velocity formulas, okay, deflection angle, mean wheel diameter, jet ratio, number of buckets and runner, size of bucket, number of jets. So as all these things we discussed in the last class, okay, how to obtain them and some formulas. So based upon all these things, formulas, power efficiency and all these design aspects. So I think in the last class, we have solved some problems. Okay, hope you understood this. So some of you may have some doubts with respect to this problem where I have taken pi as 180 means 180 minus deflection angle. Generally we will take this deflection angle with respect to V2, that is beta. But in this problem we have taken with respect to pi, that is VR2. Okay. So it's generally with respect to Pelton wheel turbine, we will take with respect to VR2. Okay, so if they don't mention, if they mention with respect to V2, then you can take with respect to V2. If they don't mention anything, just take pi as 180 minus pi. That's it. So 180 minus deflection angle. So in always Pelton wheel turbine, okay, so either they will give pi value or they won't give. So if they give deflection angle, you can find out the pi value as 180 minus deflection angle. Okay, so remember that. So in case in the Pelton wheel turbine, again we have seen one problem, second problem. I hope you have understood this. And I think I have given one more problem for your homework. Very simple, just please wait. Right, sorry for the disturbance, some important call I have to attend. Right, so I have given one more problem as a homework. So I hope that you have solved this problem. Okay, so I think you have solved this, so no need to explain again. Okay, so if anybody has any doubts with respect to this problem, you can please ask. Otherwise, I will proceed to the next topic. Okay, right, so this we have seen in the last class. I think also we have started something about reaction turbines in the last class. Okay, so let me go to the next page where I can explain about the reaction turbines and we'll take an example of Francis turbine. So as you can see in the screen, so we started discussing about what is known as reaction turbine. So earlier we have seen what is known as impulse turbine. So impulse turbine means, so at inlet as well as at inlet we have only kinetic energy, and throughout the process we have only atmospheric pressure. So that we call it as impulse turbine. And we have said that Pelton wheel turbine is an example of impulse turbine. So whereas coming to reaction turbines, in the reaction turbines, the both pressure energy as well as kinetic energy are available at inlet as well as throughout the process of the generation of the electrical power in turbine. And very importantly, there is no atmospheric pressure is available. So no air is entered into the turbine. I repeat again, no air will enter into the turbine of reaction turbines. Okay. So it means there is a casing over the turbine such that no air will enter. So completely the casing and turbine filled with water. Okay. So there is no air. Only water will be available between casing and turbine. Okay. So that is called airtight casing. Okay. So you can ensure that no air will enter. So when no air will enter, only pressure energy and kinetic energy are available. No atmospheric pressure will be available. Okay. So this is what we call as reaction turbine. So the example of reaction turbines already we have seen. One is Francis turbine and other one is Kaplan turbine. So we will first take Francis turbine, then we talk about Kaplan turbine. Okay, so we can define Francis turbine as, already we have seen in the case of classification of turbines, that Francis turbine is a inward radial flow turbine. Okay, it means the water flows from outside towards runner. That is called inward radial flow turbine. So I will show you the diagram of Francis turbine, how this inward flow will occur. Okay, so it is an inward flow radial flow turbine, reaction turbine. All we have seen the reaction turbine, and very importantly, this Francis turbine works under medium heads. So the head of water at the inlet of turbine is medium. Okay, it cannot take the lower value or higher value. Okay, so it works under medium head, medium specific speed, and medium discharge. Okay, so this is all about Francis turbine definition, or you can say what is Francis turbine. Okay, so remember this whole sentence of Francis turbine. So as we have discussed for Pelton wheel turbine, the construction and working process of Francis turbine. So here also we discuss about what is the construction and working process of Francis turbine, as we have discussed for Pelton wheel turbine. Okay, so try to concentrate here, and I will discuss about this construction and working process of the Pelton Francis turbine. Okay, so these things may be also very important for your exam point of view, the theory part of Francis turbine. Okay, so try to concentrate on this Francis turbine. Right, so generally, So generally Francis turbine consists of four major parts. Okay, so Francis turbine consist of four major parts. Okay. So the first one is, so as we have seen in the case of Francis Pelton wheel turbine, so we have first one is casing. So here also we have casing. This casing we call it as spiral casing. Okay, so why it is called spiral casing, I will tell you when I discuss about diagram. So it's also known as scroll casing. So both are same, spiral casing or scroll casing. The second part of the Francis turbine is guide wheel. Okay, guide wheel. So guide wheel has some guide vanes. So again, I will tell you about, so what are these guide wheel and guide vanes. The third part is, so these guide wheels also known as fixed vanes. Third one is runner with moving vanes. Runner with moving vanes. The last one is draft tube. Okay. So generally these are the four major parts of the Francis turbine. Okay, so as you can see, when you compare with the Pelton wheel turbine, so we have a casing in Pelton wheel turbine, but that is a kind of open casing. We have a large space between turbine and casing, so that air will enter into the turbine. But here we are saying it is a spiral casing or stall casing. So why it is called spiral? What is the purpose of it? We will discuss. And second one is guide wheel. Okay, so it's a kind of wheel like a runner, but it has some special vanes called guide vanes. These guide vanes are fixed. We cannot change once you fix the bolts. Okay, so what is the purpose of this guide wheel and guide vanes? We'll discuss. The third part is a runner. Okay, as we have seen in the case of Pelton wheel turbine, so we have a runner that will rotate because the vanes are moving. When the vanes are moving, so the runner also will be moving. So because of the rotation of the runner, we are getting the power and efficiency in case of Francis turbine. Okay, so this runner, it's same as that of the Pelton wheel turbine. The last one is draft tube. So this is very important special feature of the reaction turbines. So both Francis turbine as well as Kaplan turbine has this particular part called draft tube. Okay, so this has very, very important application in reaction turbines. So we will discuss this separately even again after completion of the Kaplan turbine draft tube theory. Okay, so we'll see, depending upon time, we will discuss about draft tube theory. But in generally, we will discuss about what is the purpose of draft tube providing in reaction turbines like Francis turbine and Kaplan turbine. So what is the purpose of providing this draft? So it is very, very important, a special feature in reaction turbine. So we will not see any draft tube in Pelton wheel turbine. Okay. So we will look at all these four parts of the Francis turbine one by one, their purpose, and with some diagram. Okay. So very, very important part for your exam point of view. So please wait. Right, so again, sorry. Right, so let us discuss about these four parts with the help of diagram. Okay. So generally, when you talk about any reaction turbine, okay, so the general layout of the reaction turbine is like this. Okay, so we have a penstock like this. So this is a penstock coming out from the dam. At the end, we have a nozzle. Okay, and so generally we have a turbine. The turbine may be Pelton wheel turbine or Francis turbine or Kaplan turbine. Okay, so generally the reaction turbine layout will be like this. Okay, so we'll be having some kind of the reaction turbine like this. So in this particular part, so this is a penstock. Okay, so this is a penstock. This is a penstock and this is a nozzle. So the water will be coming through this penstock and then to nozzle, and the jet will strike the turbine, that is the runner, the blades of the runner in the turbine. So for example, this particular rectangular portion is a reaction termite. So this reaction, so in this particular rectangular portion, you may have Kaplan turbine or Francis turbine. So I'm just drawing the general layout of reaction turbines. So this is the penstock. From dam, the water will be coming. Okay, and from this reaction turbine, we have a shaft connected like this, and we have a generator. We have generator. So this is shaft. And very importantly, so in this reaction turbine, we have a draft tube like this. So this is a draft tube. So this is how a draft tube in general looks like. Okay, so we will see what is this draft tube, what is the purpose. So generally, this draft tube is embedded in tail race. Already we know what is tail race. So the tail race will collect the water after it strikes the turbine. So for example, this is the level of water in tail race. Okay. So generally, this draft tube is submerged in this tail race channel. Okay. So this is your tail race. This is draft tube. So the water will be flowing through this draft tube and falls into tail race. Okay. So this is a special arrangement we provide in the reaction turbine. So this is a general layout of reaction turbine. General layout of, you can say, power plant. General layout of power plant with reaction turbine. Reaction turbine. Okay, so this is a general layout how a reaction turbine, how a power plant looks with a reaction turbine. Okay, so having seen this general layout of power plant, the reaction turbine, so let me now, we are discussing about Francis turbine. Okay, so let us discuss about the Francis turbine construction and working process. So using these four major parts: spiral casing, guide wheel, runner with moving vanes, draft. Let us discuss this particular four parts by taking Francis turbine. Then we take Kaplan turbine. Okay, for as examples of the reaction turbines. Okay, right. So let me draw the figure for Francis turbine. Then I will discuss that Francis turbine, the help of all these four parts. So the diagram looks maybe somewhat confusing you, but it's very simple actually, the Francis turbine diagram. But you have to concentrate from the beginning. So how I'm going to draw the figure. Okay, but very, it's very simple actually. Okay. So but try to concentrate on the diagram of the Francis turbine. Okay. So as I said before, Francis turbine is a inward radial flow turbine. Okay. So inward radial flow means the water travels from outside to towards inner side, towards the runner of the blades. So generally, the diagram of the Francis turbine looks like this. Say, so this is your penstock, which is coming from the dam. Okay, so for example, this is your penstock. Okay, so this is a penstock. I'm just drawing the Francis turbine, how it looks like. Okay, so this is a penstock. This is a penstock, a large pipe diameter, which is coming from the dam. Okay. Okay, so in the Francis turbine, this penstock is directly connected to the runner of turbines. Okay, and this particular Francis turbine has four major parts. One is spiral casing, guide wheel, runner, and draft tube. So all these four we can show in this particular diagram. Okay, Francis turbine. Right. So how this Francis turbine looks like? Let me draw it. So from water from the dam flows through penstock, okay, flows through penstock like this. The water will flow through penstock like this, and then we have a casing called spiral casing. Okay, so we have a casing called spiral casing. So let me draw the spiral casing of the branch turbine. It's a bit difficult for me to draw it in the notepad, as it has some kind of circular shape of the spiral casing. So let me take some time and try to draw the figure. Not proper. Let me try out again. So I'm trying to draw the spiral casing. So let me just see how it goes, the figure. So this is a kind of spiral casing. So this spiral casing covers the turbine. So inside we have a turbine, so that no air will enter into the turbine. Okay, so that no air will enter into the turbine. Say for example, so the outer part is called a spiral casing connecting the penstock. And inner we have inside the spiral casing we have a guide wheel. So let me draw the guide wheel here. So this is a kind of guide wheel. Okay, so it's a kind of guide wheel, and inside we have shaft. So this is a shaft. Okay, so this is a shaft. So over the shaft we have a runner. So this is our runner. Okay, this is our runner. We draw it again. So let me draw out this. This is a shaft. Okay, it's a shaft. And it over the shaft we have a road. We have a runner. So this is our runner. And this is outer runner, outer diameter of the runner. And it has some thickness. Okay, so this is how a Francis turbine looks like. Okay, let me draw out the vanes, the curved vanes, the moving vanes, and the guide vanes. So as I said before, this part is our guide wheel. So let me just take this another color so that you can easily understand. So actually you need to draw a perfect circle kind of thing. So this part is our guide wheel. So this red color part is guide wheel, and the guide wheel has the guide vanes. So these are the guide vanes. So these are guide vanes. So I'm just drawing a single layer of the curved vanes. So these are the guide vanes. Okay, so this part is nothing but your guide wheel, and these are nothing but guide vanes. So all also called as fixed. So these vanes do not move. They are just like that. Okay, so they are fixed with bolts, so that they cannot move. So guide wheel cannot move, so therefore guide vanes also cannot move. They are just fixed. So all the guide vanes are fixed with bolts and nuts on the periphery of the guide wheel. They will not move. Okay. So all the guide vanes are fixed on the periphery of the guide wheel. Okay. Then we have a rotor here. We have a rotor. Okay. We have a rotor, also called runner. So along the runner, we have the vanes are attached, and these vanes are movable. Okay, so we call them as runner with moving vanes. So let me draw the curved vanes which are movable. Okay, so this green color lines indicates clear curved vanes. So this indicates moving curved vanes. You can say moving vanes. Okay, so moving vanes, and this particular part is called runner. Already we know that runner always moves. As we have seen in the case of belt and wheel turbine, always runner will rotate. So you can see that on the runner, periphery of the runner, the vanes are attached. So those vanes are also movable. As runner is movable, the vanes of the runner also movable. Whereas guide wheel is fixed and guide vanes are also fixed. They do not move. So we will discuss about what is the purpose of guide wheel, guide vanes, and already we know what is the purpose of runner and runner vanes, because they will move, they will produce speed, and they will produce power efficiency. Okay. So apart from this runner and moving vanes, so what is the purpose of having guide wheel and guide vanes? Okay, we will discuss that. So therefore, this is how a general Francis turbine looks like. Okay. So this is a penstock generally, which is connected to dam. Okay, so from dam the water will flow like this. Okay, so the water flow like this. Okay, so as you can see, immediately to the flow of this the water flow from penstock, the first opening is the guide wheel. Okay, we have first the outer layer of this penstock is guide wheel. As you can see, the red color guide wheel. So the water will first enter into this guide wheel like this, and then flow like this, and again enter like this, and flow like this, again enter like this. The water flow like this and enter into this guide wheels. So the water will be keep on flowing as well as the water will be entering into turbine through this guide vanes. Okay. So water will go like this, water enters like this. The water will go like this, water enters in this guide vanes. So like this, water flow like here and the water enter like this. So this is how the water takes place. So as you can see here, the water is flowing from outward to inward. Okay, so the water is flowing from outward to inward towards the runner. So that's why Francis turbine is known as inward radial flow turbine. So the water flows radially towards the runner. Okay, so as you can see, the direction of the flow of water from penstock to runner through the guide vanes, it's called inward radial flow turbine. Okay, so I hope you are able to observe the figure carefully, properly. So this is how the direction of the water takes place in this Francis turbine. Okay, so try to figure out each and every parameter what I have written here, like guide wheel, guide vanes, moving vanes, runner. Okay, so all these things. So this inner part, okay, so this part, let me write down this. So this part is our shaft. Okay, so the shaft is directly coupled to generator where we get power. Okay, so that I cannot show here because it is, I have drawn some kind of cross section of the Francis turbine. So but in generally the shaft is connected to the generator. Okay, so this is how a Francis turbine looks like. Okay, so the outer part, so this outer part is called this out